As we mentioned in the previous video, visual cues are one of the main ingredients to an effective visualization. In the next couple of videos, we'll cover some of the main visual cues that you can use to represent data in your charts. The first one that we're going to discuss is position. When using position as a visual cue, you compute value by looking at the position of a point compared to the position of others in the same space or coordinate system. Here, this would translate to this point's x and y coordinate. Position is a useful encoding because it takes up less space than other visual cues. It's really space efficient. Each data point is simply represented as a dot. Also, points often have the same size, which allows you to easily identify trends, clusters, and outliers by plotting all of your data at once. But if you have too many data points in your plot, it can be a challenge to identify what each point represents. For example, imagine that this chart were covered with dozens of green dots just like this one. It might be hard for us to identify individual dots and really understand what they mean, or what data they correspond to. Another commonly used visual cue is length, which is often encountered in the form of bar charts. The length of a bar indicates the intensity or value of your data point. For example, the longer the bar, the greater the absolute value. One more encoding that's very common is angle. Angle ranges from 0 to 360 degrees on a circle. Angles are commonly used to represent parts of a whole. A pie chart is a really common example of this. The sum of the wedges in this pie complete a circle and give us 360 degrees. One negative aspect to using angles as a visual encoding is that human eyes can have a difficult time differentiating angles. For example, 25 degrees and 30 degrees may look very similar. Because of this, angle is an encoding that you may want to avoid if you're trying to show very small differences.